Hey, Kevin, what in the world are you doing now?
Oh, boy. I am trying to get that magnet to stick. There we go. I was playing with these spun metal balls here. I was going to start a new sculpture, and it requires some TIG work. So I thought I'd get out my longevity TIG Weld 250 AC/DC over here and do a little TIG welding. But first I got to set the machine up. Doesn't take very long. Here, come here, check it out. Just flip the switch. Because I have been using this machine on aluminum. I was using it on the seed sculpture, so now I got to switch it back to steel. You can see right here it's in AC. That's for aluminum welding. Okay, now I'm ready to weld steel. That's all it takes. I'm going to leave the pulse on high and leave my pulse current at about 40 amps. My frequency and my width I'll leave alone. The upslope, downslope, I'll leave that alone. Pre-flow, all that other stuff is set pretty much the way I like it. So now I just need some filler rod for steel. That's on the other side of the cart, of course. And we'll come over here and we'll get to play with the TIG for a minute or two. So you got your helmet?
Yep.
So I've got a little 1-inch spun metal ball. And I drilled a hole in the end of it, so it's an open vessel. If this was completely closed, as soon as I started to weld on it, the air inside would superheat and it would blow the puddle out. And I'd wind up with a big hole to fill. So drill a little hole in it, and now I can just take my little piece of 1/2-inch pipe and go right over the top of that hole, and now I can just go ahead and lay a little bead around there. Let's see what we got. Got your helmet on? Those settings are not going to work.
What are you setting it to, Cap?
I turned the pulse off and went to straight DC TIG, and we'll try it that way. Need a little more juice. Okay. So get just a little tack weld on there with the TIG. And now I can come back with my rod and just go ahead and lay a bead around there.
So what did you end up setting it to?
I went to no pulse. I turned the pulse all the way off. And I went to 50, come on, about 58 amps. So now I'll come back with some rod and let's see what we can do. There's another little trick for you. You got something that wants to roll away? I'll grab some vice grips. They make great chalks. Okay, where were we? Thank you. gets that welded on. No, I'm not going to pick it up with my fingers. Not bad for blind in one eye and can't see out of the other. So let me play with this some more, and you'll see how this turns out, you know, in a little while, you know, a few days when I get it all put together. I'll see you next time.